guys, here with hopefully a quick review. Today I'm doing the Head Robots, their fourth release, as they like to point out to us, Blood the Dark Warrior. $18 accessory piece for your bludgeon. Highly recommend it. It does come with this very simple package. You can open it, you can seal it back up, no problem. The instructions are on the back if you do need them. It's very, very simple of how to get this thing going. However, there is one step that I had huge issues with that I hope you don't have yourself. Now, this does come with a replacement head that I will show off. And I never had any issues with this head. I think it fits the toy quite nicely. But what you're supposed to do, and I've wedged it in there because I have issues with this. You're supposed to rotate the head as far as you can in one direction to undo one screw. As far as you can in the direction to undo the other screw. One of the screws on mine was horribly stripped out. So I had to literally pry the head apart and pull the screw head through the back of the head there. And really scuffed it up in the process. But it is still a... I can still put it back on if I really want to, and I did kind of scrape up his little shoulder bit there, but it was a pain to get that thing off. It wasn't fun. But other than that, no issues at all. So, what comes in this set? Well, we have a replacement head, and not one, but two of new weapons, which are very, very nice. And of course, we get this little piece here, which comes into play for the tank mode. Now, putting your thing on is really easy. The head fits on with kind of just a tension fit, they call it, or a tension clip. You just pop it on, it clips right on. And if you want to pull it off again, just give it a little pull and it comes right off. I do wish this would have held a lot more securely. It clips on fine, but you see, it has kind of this wobble bobblehead effect, which I'm not a huge fan of. You can't rotate it very far at all, but the overall look is really nice. It's hard to make out a lot of these details in his face, but there is you can kind of get an idea there. Really nice kind of look. Now, the head has a feature of its own. It has two faces. This face here is kind of more of a G1 kind of face. If you pull the helmet off, which I actually had to use crazy glue to get the peg stronger, the head or the helmet fit very, very loosely, and it was hard to get to stay on. A little line of crazy glue gets that holding a lot more securely. But you see, there's your G1 head. And this one is a lot more, I think, of the recent IDW kind of look, where he has his mouth missing, a lot of circuitry kind of hanging off. You can have that if you do want. Kind of give you an idea. There's some more of the detailing. Personally, I like this one a whole lot more, so I leave it with the whole skull head kind of look. Comparison between the heads real quick, you can get an idea of how they look together. The kind of burgundy for his helmet is a bit lighter than on the new one, but it does work quite nicely. There's that. Now, the problem with Bludgeon's original weapons, this one, not so much, besides that really dull gray plastic. A big issue was the handle of the sword being the barrel for the tank mode. It's very, very thick, and you have to really pry it into his fingers. And I think I remember hearing issues of Bludgeon's fingers breaking from the stress of sliding this through. And they have done away with that entirely, with making the sword and the barrel two separate pieces entirely. So, get that back on there. So you can see, there's the barrel for the tank mode, and there is the sword together. I like this a whole lot more. The blade is a bit shorter, and you can see when you pull the barrel off, you have a really nice kind of a samurai sword handle instead of just this big bulbous thing. But the chrome is really the big selling point. This, very rubbery, very flexible. This, not so much. This will step if you do break it. But that chrome just looks really, really nice. It's really nice and thick. I've slid this into the barrel of the tank mode many, many times. Many! And I was kind of forceful at some points. Tank barrel didn't want it, but I did. And I'm not seeing any kind of scratch or anything. The only issue is there are some fingerprints that get caught on it, but just a very, very nice kind of a sword blade. And with that tank barrel not being on it, you can slide it into his hand with no problem. It just fits right in there like that. And it looks really, really nice with him. Now, of course, he does have his little dagger. And there's the original. There's the new one. Again, actually, it's about the same size. Maybe a little bit longer. But just looks fantastic. That chrome is really, really nice. And I like having it posed kind of like he's got it like that. And there's that. Now, you do have this extra piece left over. Well, you can store this right on this little turret on the back there. And there you go. Everything has its own little place, and I think it just looks great. It really brings some much-needed character to this toy, and it just looks good. I have his leg kind of bent at a weird angle. I really, really do like this kit. $18 is a fantastic deal. Now, when you are transforming him back... Oh, and just to show you, the weapons do still store in their little slots here. You can get them stored away if you do want to. That works. Now, when you are transforming him, I'm not going to just go through all the steps, but to give you an idea, sword fits in the barrel about as well as the original, maybe even a little bit better. I did have an issue with the barrel here. It had a very, very loose fit. It would pop off at the slightest tilt. What I did is put a very, very thin bit of crazy glue inside there. Very, very small amount. Let it dry, let it cure, all that kind of stuff. And it fits on with no problem. It's even a secure fit that if I just pull it straight out, it pulls the sword with it, which I don't really mind. But that just looks great. I mean, if you compare this to the original, which I always had an issue getting the sword to fit all the way in. I never really liked that too much, but I kind of just dealt with it. But you're putting this in place, and it's just a huge improvement. That looks so much better. And like before, you can open it in the back compartment here, take his dagger, it fits right inside there. Perfect storage. Now, when you are transforming him into his vehicle mode, the only issue I really do have is you have to hold his head down when you're pushing the body up. Otherwise, the helmet will get pulled off inside. So just do that, and it fits inside. You can see the arms still can fold up, and there's plenty of clearance for the helmets. I'm going to transfer this off camera real quick to just show you how well it works and all that fun stuff. And there you go. You can see the helmet, plenty of clearance inside. There's no harm of these getting kind of messed up at all. It's nice, sturdy plastic. The tank retains all the same features as before. The turret looks great. Just to give you an idea again. All right, there's this with the new barrel and all that kind of stuff. Just to give you an idea again. Just a huge improvement. Like, you have to wonder why they went for that gray to begin with, besides being cheap. But I do like it. $18 for this kit is really a fantastic deal. It's my first purchase through Head Robots. I probably won't get any more, considering Bludgeon's the only one I really have of all their upgrade kits. But I really do like how this looks, and I would say pick it up. If you have Bludgeon already, $18 is well worth it for this kit. And you can find it at pretty much all of the big websites. TF Source, Big Bad Toy Store, they've all got them. I got mine through Big Bad Toy Store, so that's just my personal preference. But I would highly suggest picking it up. It looks great. And you can keep the head around, you know, just put it back on later on, unless you really kind of butcher yours up like I did. So there you go, guys. Hope you have a great day, and I dropped the head. I'll see you around. Take care.